What do you call that little box you got?
Soundbox. Soundboard.
Oh, yeah, soundboard. That works.
Oh, what the fuck's on my computer? What time is it?
Hey everyone, welcome to Let's Draw number 8, and I promise you, this one's going to be not as annoying, and hopefully we'll have things running stable. Today I am joined by James Stewart. James?
It's average here, I think, yeah. Alright.
Just average?
Just average. Yeah, I'm running low on the REMs.
That works?
It's okay.
So we decided we're going to try to make a mech mod today. Are you into that?
I'm into it.
Cool. And Let's Draw is a show where we take your guys's, suggestions, input, feedback into the way that we make something, and you guys get to see it come to life along with us. If it's good, then eventually it'll probably go into production somewhere at some point. And the coolest thing about it is you guys get to put your names to it. And you get to do that by going into the chat. So whether you're on Periscope or on YouTube or on Facebook, you can put your name, your input, your feedback in there, and it'll show up on the chat, and we'll do something about it.
So what are we going to do about it?
What are we going to do about it? We are going to draw.
Put some names on things.
Put some names on some things, that's right.
Yeah, exactly that. Right. I'm just going to do some sharing, because I ran out of REMs, and then nothing was happening. So
I think I spam the hell out of everything, so I think we're good.
I want to get some UK representing, yo. Because it's late, so we might get some drunk English people.
That'd be good. Keep it rowdy. Cool. We're all set up. Somebody said, Facebook vid not working.
Damn it.
No, it seems to be working. Maybe just their internet connection isn't working, but if you are with us, give us a chat and drop a comment in there so we know that you're alive. I can see we got.
I love it. It sounds like is that the radio station you listen to, the NPR or whatever it is?
Sometimes.
Hey guys, let us know you're here and listening.
God, yeah, I know.
Give us a call or message us on.
the one really good show. Morning Becomes Eclectic. He is a really good DJ, and he has an incredible selection and taste in music, and he is, will just put you to sleep. So, how big should we make this? Let's start out here with defining our outside diameter. 22, 24.
So it's gonna be
tubby.
How's people feeling about chubby chubbies? Because I got my little prototype number 2 Dogecoin around the corner.
Do you?
I'd get it, but it's covered in liquid.
It's probably a good reason why none of the chats were showing up, and that would be because I didn't connect the chat client. Now it's hooked up. Jake says 22 millimeters. Cool.
25 from Doran. Oh, here he is. I told you there'd be rowdy, drunk English people around.
Good.
Dirty day.
The dirty tea.
Horrible, horrible man. Still the ones you guys gave me. Still got something else I gave you, Steve.
24 millimeter tube.
That could work.
That could work. Two votes for 24. It's getting competitive now.
Yes. Definitely the herbs. He's not drunk, he's sick.
Oh, poor guy.
Only time he's not drunk is if he's ill.
Alright, let's see. How tall should we make this guy? This might actually, since I don't design mech mods that often, this one's probably going to be a lot more of me measuring things.
When was the Dogecoin? 2014, 15?
I think it was 2015. Well back, right? Yeah, I think so.
Long time ago.
Let's find out.
It's so funny because obviously we chat to Kurt now and again, and he had his run-ins with the he who shall not be mentioned. And then just the other day when we were doing the discount on the Dogecoin, some other guy was like, oh, you guys are cool, but fuck the other guy. Oh my god, has he screwed him around as well? It's like a typhoon through the industry, just destroying everything.
That sucks.
Yeah.
Let's see, when was this published? 2015, so yeah, mid-2015.
Okay, so we're doing a new one.
Yeah, we are doing a new one. Yeah, Steve knows better than I do. He has better memory. 26650 stacked. You'd have to get the original Doge mod for that.
Oh yeah, I love that guy.
Put two of them together. Hey Chad, try refreshing it. I just checked, it said it was working. I don't know why, wouldn't it be? I got a solid wired up connection today. So we should be good to go. All right. What was I doing? I was measuring an 18650. And I might measure a mod for good measure.
Zoe Victoria Clark is live streaming at the same time as us. I feel like we're having a clash of rating.
Who's that?
She's some drunk vape model.
Oh.
She's cool.
She English one?
Mm-hmm. She's from Birmingham. She has a delightful accent.
Okay, so the reason why it's 18650 is because it's 18 millimeters round and 65 millimeters tall. Should remember that because it's in the name.
Go figure.
So if it's... Okay, 65 millimeters tall, and then we're going to want space for the contacts, and I'd say 10 millimeters for the contacts. Let's see. Yeah, 10. 10 on each side, so 20, 85. So we'll go ahead and make this guy 85 millimeters. And then this is easy. We'll cut a hole in it. I didn't even think mechs were still a thing, but six lipos mech. What about something that can take 2,700 cells? That's probably the next thing. That's what Jay says. I don't even know what. I just wanted to see John work it out. Let's, James, can you track down 2700s?
I am right on it.
Make that 18.5 millimeter hole. Put a cut through it.
Put a bird on it.
Looks good. You know, I could swear those walls are really thick, and that people run a lot. I mean, we run a lot more slack in these things. I just don't feel right about that. Hold on, let me. I'll be right back. Keep people entertained. I'm gonna go try to.
I don't know how to do that.
Yeah. Sorry. I got it. I'm gonna go try to rummage my vape collection for a mech mod to see if I have something better to reference this off of.
What are you using? He's off. So in that case, Jay, I'll be looking at the 2700 batteries. What? Has anyone actually used these before? Ooh, okay. Sanyo. It's a remote control car that was Sanyo powered. It's pretty sweet. Okay. Nineteen point 9 millimeter. You just tossing stuff around back there. Pin the measurements, dude.
Huh?
I pinned the measurements.
Oh, you have?
Yeah.
Cool. And that's of the battery, right?
Yeah.
That sounds much more interesting, to be honest.
Mm. No, definitely.
Now, what are the utilities of this battery, guys? Yeah. Let's do some research. I'm all about that.
So the chemistry is NCR. The nominal capacity is 3,100 milliamps per hour. Nominal voltage is 3.6 volts. Discharge is 30 amps max continuous. And the positive pin is flat.
Mm.
Right? Rechargeable, yes, of course. Protected, no, unprotected. And the weight is 61.2. Make it fairly cheap.
Check this guy out. I clicked on this because it says, have you heard about these batteries?
Today we are talking about iJoy SickPad, okay? They got new things for you. All that is a mechanical Moses. Mechanical Moses is a very huge. Inside the battery is very different. I never saw this battery before. It's a 2700 battery. Is more bigger than the 18650 battery and smaller than the 26650 batteries. Okay, so these magnetic thermals, they're writing here, this is a 27 millimeter. Last time I called it mm and they laugh at me. Okay, at America they didn't call it mm, they call it millimeter. So this is a 27 millimeter out of my dripper mechanical modes, sorry, and it's a RDA 24 mm in diameter. Okay, this 24 mm and 27 mm. Okay, so this is quite heavy a bit, and it got a sleeve too. Actually this is a sleeve and this is the extra sleeve, rainbow color. And these mechanical modes, they give it the name, okay, this is a Wonder Vapeco. Wonder Vapeco 27.
Well, he seems pretty G'd up about this.
Right?
Yeah, he's excited.
Wonder Vapeco.
Got it.
Clapton coil screws and O-rings.
Got
and
it.
And this is a 2700 batteries. Okay, it's more longer a bit.
Definitely India.
And more thicker a bit.
Yeah,
and
he is a little rough.
This is the mechanical modes. the best things, it right?
Yep, yep.
Wonder Vipco.
Yep, yep, yep.
So this, yeah, you can push it. Wonderful. Okay, push it like this.
Yep,
okay.
It's a floating pin, and that is a really shit design. Okay. Jesus Christ, that's scary.
Here,
your magnetic pin.
And then just twist.
Easy.
Lock. Open.
Basic
right?
Lock. Yep.
And
yep,
there's
yep,
the
yep.
Button.
Yep,
a
yep,
little
yep.
Bit sound because still new. Pad
yep.
RDA.
Yep.
These things.
Yep.
Put it back on. Open it up. Coils that I'm gonna build today.
Okay. All right. Thank you. I'm about it, guys. I want to do something fucking different.
It?
Yeah. Let's get. Let me go and grab these specs. Mike says, "Yes, iJoy, the world-renowned battery manufacturer."
Yeah, they're like up there with Sony and Tesla.
Yep. Don't be surprised if you know it's probably just a 18650 with a 2700.
It's got like a shim on it all the way around.
Yeah, it's just
extra plastic for density.
Just fine. Shimmed around. Okay, dimensions are. It looks good. 19.9 × 70. Thomas is demanding where the spinner's at. James, you gotta produce. Put up or shut up, buddy.
I left a review on a spinner today on Amazon, and I said that I was quite disappointed. One star, it didn't cure any autism. And Amazon let it through, because I'm a Prime member. I've got my Alexas. I'm a big fan of their Audible. They were like, yeah, give him that. He can have that. It's fine. So I got it. And I screenshot it, and I'm going to save it for some good drops, so for some premium trolling.
Okay, so... It's 20 millimeters diameter, right? And it's a little bit taller.
Yeah. Well, that was Sanyo. I'm assuming they all have the same standardization. Let me just
yeah, the, yeah.
Others.
The name.
No, the iJoy one is 20.4 millimeters. So
it's 20.4. So there's some slack in there, right?
Yeah. There always is, isn't there? It's sort of sometimes the rattle, sometimes the tighten.
Yeah. Hmm. All right, we're gonna do a rough shape today, guys, and then I'm crashing right now at a family member's apartment while my living situation gets figured out, and
homeless again.
What? Well, that's,
homeless again. That's San Francisco for you. A homeless epidemic.
Yeah.
Everyone's in the street in SF.
No, it's just no. I had to get my. Long story. Anyways, but since I'm in San Francisco, I should be able to source a one of these batteries, I would think, fairly quickly, if not from a vape shop, from a vendor, which is one of the things I didn't like about being in Stockton, was that
that's true.
I had a lot of trouble sourcing stuff. Situation. Yes, exactly. That's why I don't have any mods to reference right now, because of all my stuff's packed up in boxes. All right, cool, guys. Let's modify this. So should we still keep it 24 millimeters? Because I think we could probably fit this 20 millimeter battery inside of it. I don't see any reason why not.
Mike's saying it's already a no-go because the standard 4.2 volt charger won't work in everyone's cheap ass night core. We have to take the masses with us. We have to elevate them.
That's true. Yeah, we have to drag them with us. So I mean,
because we were the first to make a dedicated wide airflow RDA back in 2012.
True.
So hashtag. Something original, something we're here first, something, I don't know. We're not good at this sort of stuff. We're not hyped, but we do things first, so.
Well, let's do 25 millimeters, just to play it on the safe side.
Steve has put, so far we have a metal cylinder. Well done, guys.
Yeah,
hey, what is vaping? It's pretty much what we deal with is metal cylinders. With occasional tribal etching or scorpions.
Yes.
Hashtag melted insulators. There we go. uh, That's the worst thing about the TPD is you can't have fun with the packaging anymore. It has to be all bloody proper. And I'm like, no more Ron Pauls and Willy Wonka's on the box.
Completely screwed that one up. All right. Yeah, cut it. Cut it. I think that'll work. We also have to modify this. You said it was 70 millimeters tall?
70.1.
Okay, that's cool. So we just bump this up to 90.
19.9 millimeters times 70.1, and they are Sanyos. Any plans for a 34 millimeter Doge? What are these people on? They're fucking dinner plate sized tubes. Don't screenshot that. I've never done this before. I love how everyone's trying to second guess the next dimensions for the Doge. Not telling anyone.
Well, you know, the catamizer is the big one.
34 millimeters is officially robot penis territory. Prepared for the singularity.
Yes.
Sign me up.
You really need. Yeah.
We'll already know how to suck robot dick. You'll be obsolete instantly. No, I disagree. No, we're going to be like in prison, you know, like the girly ones do all right because they just become the bitches. That'll be us. Papers are going to be fine when the singularity happens. We will. We'll be like delightful little hand servants, like eunuchs to the robot overlords.
Mm. 66.6 millimeter
Doge confirmed.
Yes, exactly.
D, we actually did make a 16 millimeter squonking pop RDA in the last Let's Draw, so maybe that will come to market fairly soon. Thomas wants to know if we're sticking with 510 or changing that. They're not that brave.
I'd like to. I think I went and rant on it last week about that. I'd really like to if I had my way. If I was dictating the way you vape.
We tried. We tried dictating and nobody listens to us. So
that's true.
There's that. I'd like to see an 8mm Doge for blue batteries, please. Hey, it could be done. That'd be amazing. Just jump all over Vipes and Blue's products and just replace the top bit with our stuff. They can do all the work. Dirty D says it's like removing the headphone jack.
Mm.
Yeah, we should use like, what's that? A Wi-Fi power type thing. You know, the IKEA standard. Just feed power to the RDA through magnetic waves.
You know, I really thought that was going to be bigger.
It's not that convenient.
It's really? I just don't think it's high enough amperage out. Tesla's probably rolling in his grave right now.
Poor guy.
Poor implementations of his tech.
Mm. He would have vaped.
You think Tesla would have vaped? Do you guys think Tesla would have vaped?
Defo. Carl's a kook. Sell a Doge Van de Graaff for the basement wireless vaping within 10 feet. Only for basements. We only do the basement pack.
Yeah.
No one's allowed above ground. Tristan says IKEA is a shell company for meatballs. I genuinely think it is.
Meat.
It's pretty much the only reason I go there.
Well, I guess it's horse meat, right? So that works.
Yeah, that's good. I like horse meat. I don't want people getting knickers in a twist about that. If you had to rate animals, right? A horse is definitely above a cuckoo.
Uh-huh.
Right, so I want to eat the higher meat. I'm horse all day long. Give me it. Thomas says we should go for an 810. Horse is delicious. Yeah, horse is delicious. The French eat horse, and they're fine.
They're fine.
Sort of.
Yeah, sort right. Of, yeah.
They'll do.
They make great decisions.
No comment. The best thing about Brexit is that we get to do all that whole empire battling over the globe again. That's going to be good.
True. All right, look at that.
There's no point being British unless you can squabble with a friend.
Yes. Pure protein. Actually, I really do like the meatballs, but I never get the meatballs when I go there. I could just get the hot dogs and the soda. Do they do hot dogs and soda?
Yeah, they do. For a pound.
For a pound, exactly. It's cheap.
So cheap.
It's nothing like our Costco hot dogs and sausage, which I will say is better. The American version, you get more meat, even though it's most definitely mystery meat.
Brexit is England's dash north of the Maginot Line. Take that. Yeah, I hope there's no French people online, and we have to be quite careful because we do have a French vendors to congregate. But yeah, that they're not surrendering this time. They're just—it's a shrug. It's not even a flag now. They're like, "Yeah, go on there, Germany. Away you go."
Yep.
There you go, President Merkel. What? I'm just saying.
It's true.
She's a powerful woman. I have a lot of respect for Angela Merkel, but no one else in Europe can stand up to her. Only Theresa May, the psychopath.
I have a lot of respect for her in a creepy kind of East German way, but.
Yeah, yeah. She's grafting.
Yep.
She's the woman out of Austin Powers, you know? Thomas has put Le Pen ain't that bad. Well, she didn't win, which is pretty French.
Did you see her nieces are dropping out?
Really?
Yeah, I'm heartbroken. I'm absolutely heartbroken. She says she's going to look for a life away from politics, and if it's not modeling, I think I'm going to I die a little bit inside.
Bad times. Well, I'm going to get my stalk on. What's her name?
Do you guys remember what Marine Le Pen's niece's name? Marion. Marion Le Pen.
Marion. They're all the same name, because her dad was Marin, wasn't it?
Yeah. It's all very similar. But you will die inside when you see her dreams. And you will wonder what you've been doing with your life this whole time, and then possibly feel like you might need to sort
your
shit
out. I have a bit
out.
Of a soft spot for Ivanka Trump, so. Oh. Okay. Oh man,
that's right.
I tell you what, Marine Le Pen was quite attractive when she was younger as well.
Yes. But Marion is
just... all French. Most French women are pretty attractive anyway.
Cool.
Hey, Corey. Good to see you, man.
Is Corey in our chat?
He is. Yeah, boy.
Corey, you should just come on just to talk shit.
We're making silences, Corey. That's what we're doing.
Yep.
He's in his dream element now.
If you want, if you don't have Zoom installed, I can give you a phone number you can call in and just chat shit with us.
Yeah, you're in front of a computer, Corey. We can hook you up.
No. He can actually use a telephone and call. Zoom
yeah,
is cool
yeah,
like
if he's
that.
On a, if he's on the thingy, Bob.
Yeah, that's
he's
true.
He's pretty little face. Because he's growing a beard. Now he's out of the forces. He's like, it's time. Give me the beard. And I'm like, good boy. Get it on you. You wank to Trump.
Yes.
Christopher says China's checking in, ready to clone. Yeah, we're standing by. We've got translators. Standing by.
Over on YouTube, Sonic says Flesh Doge. No. That's on our other live stream. You have to subscribe to the other channel. Which, speaking of which, if you haven't subscribed on YouTube yet, you're totally missing out. Facebook can be kind of a technology ghetto, and I assure you that the stuff will be on YouTube longer and way more fun for a longer time. But if you're on Facebook as well, there's a button on your mobile phone that says follow. Hit follow next to that. Then you'll know when we are online and ready to start trolling. So we got the basics of a tube.
Mike says, I never had a problem with clone mechs. It's a metal tube. You don't call a glass made in China a clone glass. Yeah,
exactly.
Some people might.
Okay, so we've got a tube.
I mic'd up, but that's interface. Yeah, send that guy a Zoom link, man.
Send him a Zoom link?
Okay. Send him a Zoom link, yeah.
Invite. All right, let me...
Thomas Wood, can you explain the name Congravape?
Ooh,
we saw a company in China, and we thought, hey, we'll copy that name. So we cloned the name of the Chinese company. I'm not going to do an impression. I'm just going to be wary here. There's no impressions happening today. No, okay, so... 2011 November-ish time, right?
Yeah, that's about right.
Yeah, so we wanted to start an e-liquid company because that's where the cool people hang out. And what we were thinking was doing a kind of like subscription thing, like a juice in a box, but before anyone else had done that. And we worked with Epic Juice. In the end, we went through quite a few companies. And Epic Juice, we got on with. Prices were fine. They were great manufacturing facilities, blah, 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 blah. We released this juice. It was 120 millimeters of juice. It was $60 a month.
I think it was less than
bucks?
That.
Less, yeah, to maybe 25 bucks, I think, maybe, in fact. And every month, you get 120 mils of juice through the post. And that was the idea. And everyone, and this is why we go back to hating Reddit, everyone hated the idea. They called it bathtub swag or whatever it was, and we were just ripped, and we couldn't say Epic's name because then we would lose things and they would lose things, and there was a contractual agreement, so we had to be quite vague about where the juice came from, so that didn't help matters either. And the industry was very, very tribal back then, and there's a bit of a wild west, so we built a platform. And the name was kind of a jam around the term congregate, so the actual dictionary term. And also there's a gaming website and stuff where people join in and stuff. And yeah, so Congra, and then banging on vape, because everyone seems to just stick on vape at the end of things. And yeah, it turned out that people were more interested in buying discounted Sony VTC3s at the time, and clone Stingrays. And stuff. So yeah. Ah, look at the beard. Yes. Brilliant. No way. Jesus.
Speak up, Corey.
Can you hear us?
Nobody can see him because he hasn't he's not using his mic.
Ah. Does that make sense? The whole Congregate thing? It just became a crowdfunding thing, and then we had a few upsets with some suppliers and project creators. And so we decided to make our own gear. And the V1 Doge was that guy. And he was 2013, give or take.
Yeah, it was about, yeah.
And then we've just been doing that ever since. And we've never really fallen into the trap of trying to be too hyped. We've just done our thing and enjoyed every minute of it. And yeah, it's tons of fun. And
Sheldon says, I made a ton of money off those VTCs. How did you do that, Sheldon?
Yeah, I remember. So my family weren't too happy about me ditching my very prestigious yachting company, because Bon and I worked on a project where we were booking marinas for yachts. And we'd been slaving away for like 2 years and got very little progress.
Yeah,
and
then I suddenly think that worked.
We
yeah, I'll be there in a sec.
Oh, he's gone.
He's running around. Everybody, this is Corey.
What's up? Can you guys hear me?
Yeah, yes. Loud and clear.
Hello, Jesus.
Oh, yeah, you like this?
I love it, man.
Sweet face armor, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm all bummed out right now, so excuse me. I'm growing neck beard.
In that face. Well,
James, you want to introduce Corey?
Yeah. No, let him do it.
Yeah. Real quick, and then I gotta go take care of something.
Children.
Yeah, children. I have two twin daughters. They're about almost a year and a half old now. So, yeah. Anyway, I'm Corey. I met John and James. I'm getting reverb back. My bad. So anyway, I met John and James quite a while ago. I think I was over in the Middle East, and I was like, hey, you know, I need some vape gear. Help me out. You know, I'm trying to kick smoking, and then it kind of just spitballed after that. Been helping them with some stuff, just providing some simple feedback here and there, and then we just kind of went from there, and we talk online all the time and provide insight on different things. You know, I give insight to John and James, and they give insight to me with my ideas and stuff. So just separated from service, and now I'm here growing this epic face beard.
Yeah.
I like that. It's separated from service, you consciously uncoupled from the forces.
Yeah, well, it was consciously and unconsciously. So they let me go, and it was kind of a mutual decision between the two of us. Nothing bad, honorable, but you know, just dealing with some stuff with my body and whatnot, broken from being over in Afghanistan. So
yeah, how you finding that?
What's up?
How you finding Civvy Street?
Oh, it's all right. We're just kind of taking some personal time and whatnot. So
chill, doesn't it? It's way chill.
Oh, no, my God, it's so much better.
Like, seriously, no one has shouted at me since I left. Like, maybe an ex-girlfriend here and there.
Oh, or, yeah, I get shouted at, just not by anybody else.
Yeah, because you can just go, shut up. Like, you say shut up in the army, like, yeah. Drill.
Speaking of getting yelled at, I got to go help out. But I'll hop on here in a second. So I'll be back here in just a few.
Cool, man.
No worries, man. Catch you in a bit. Tom. Big Tom. The hats. Okay. The hats are they're an issue. I made these amazing hats. I fell in love with those guys, and I poured a lot of even the inside and the tag, the sticker. Have you still got the sticker on yours? Yeah, even the sticker was bespoke. I really went to town on them. But they arrived about 3 months after the V3 launch, so we ended up with these amazing hats, and then kind of a tail end of the project. So the V4 will have supporting hats in electric blue and a few other tones, and I'm really excited about them because I'm actually going to launch them at a similar sort of time to the product rather than the it was just bad timing. But they're awesome. They really are. I've seen a lot of hats in the vape industry, and I always pick them up and I have a nose around, and they seem to be like from like 4 or 5 companies, and they're all, you know, they're someone else's hats, whereas the Doge hats, every single element. John, do you want to? I know you might have bad hair, but like inside, even the ribbon says Congravape, but the tag with a little dope in there. Like a lot of effort, and it's like, yeah, it's cool, isn't it? Like, yes. And I put so much effort into that, and it was so heartbreaking for them to arrive. Yeah. It says that if you need to wash it, give it to your mom. And it's like, yeah, I every single stitch on that hat I considered and designed. So it's a real shame that we're not, yeah, see, even. A cool hat. The only thing I didn't like was the snap back bit at the back.
Yeah, that's okay though, because I mean, the nature of the thing is that if we do fitted hats, right, I don't think we have the same scale as Supreme.
Yeah. And then the fitted ones, I got a Tesla one that I use when I'm doing decorating around the house, and it starts to bag out and you can't really wash it, so.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, cool. I got it. It's a really cool suggestion. What do you think about this? They're a half or one turn for the top cap and thread. I kind of like that.
We have a switch in R&D that we can grab for this, don't we?
Maybe.
I think we do. No, I think a prototype was made. Because I sent the Eng guy the Legionnaire.
That's right.
Yeah. And we said, make that out of ceramic and better. And he went, And so he did eventually. But it's in R&D. Basically, we had this switch, but we didn't really have a reason to use it. So, yeah, maybe we can use it on this.
Are you guys okay with the one turn lock and unlock feature and a threaded threading in the switch? Because I don't, I mean, let's try it. Let's one turn this. So I'm going to change this threading up.
It has to be ceramic, dude. The band.
The control band?
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll do that. If it's already finished, then I need that sent over and I will get it.
Okay. And you know, is it Limitless that have the sleeves on their tube mods?
I'm not sure.
I think so. They sell interchangeable things, a bit like the old Nokia phone covers. You can slide a new one on and fill it. We should do a ceramic sleeve. That'd be sweet as well. Then the heat won't get through so much. Because sometimes they get a little bit warm. Sometimes. I'm going to go get my my first ever mod. Hang on.
So I think what we're going to want to do for this, let me put on some music while he's gone. Okay, cool. We're going to need to make a bigger cut. Yeah, I agree, Blake. So let's drop this down to 1.25 turns for the cut. And then I'm going to deepen the cutting tool I built for this guy. This because I know this is can be slightly boring sometimes. Why not multiple threads like a gun breech, like 7 threads so that you get one complete rotation to back the whole thing out? That's true, instead of only having 2 or 3 threads. The problem with the breech is that it slides over so deep and you're not trying to take the sleeve and then the thing going into it, the plug, and then float another thing in there. Yeah.
What is that noise? Are you spinning?
That little, the yeah. That's every time the chat shows up on the screen. I think the machining term is multiple start threads. I think you're right. What we're talking about right now is making like a quick release, kind of like a silencer for a rifle type threading. That way it pushes in and then rotates on.
Where's Corey when we need him?
I know, right? Because Corey would be the guy to talk to right now about this.
Absolutely. Yeah, there's some weird things. So when we went shooting together, I could carry everything. Ammo, crates, the rifle, the pistol, everything. Apart from the silencer. He had to maintain one hand on it all the time. It's so weird.
Yeah, welcome to the United States.
It's like the AR or whatever he's using at the time, but the AR platform, whatever he was using, is like 30 rounds, full metal jacket, and a whole load of rampaging potential. And it's like silence, it's just a tube. Hold it steady. Let anyone see it. Wearing a burqa. It's madness.
Absolute madness, man.
Sheldon, if you guys are thinking about potentially doing sleeving, and you sent a link, I'm going to have a look at that link.
Ooh, that's cool.
It sounds like you're playing with a spinner, that fucking chat thing.
Sorry. You just...
Zoo!
Wait, is that what it sounds like?
No, it sounds like something being dropped, like batteries being dropped on the table. I'm just thinking, are you really clumsy or are you playing with a spinner?
Hmm. I see what you're saying, Mike, and I think I know an easier way to do it than what I'm doing.
Give me the comments. Okay, yeah. To be honest, we only really touch ceramics. We've not gone down any other route in terms of other materials, have we?
What is that made out of, that stuff that Sheldon sent?
I'm assuming acrylic, right? Does it say? It doesn't, but I'm assuming it's some sort of acrylic.
Well, so what I think he's talking about is an outer sleeve.
Yeah, I don't even make it out of ceramic. Because I don't really like anything else. I'm like bright colors. You see those tips and stuff, and I just connected with a guy called Bessie something. He's like the UK's number one drip tip maker, and he uses some really incredible materials and really bright colorful designs, but I always find it even a little bit tacky, like a little, I don't know, I'm a bit apple-fied. I like jet black and gray stainless steel, and my kitchen is testing, so that is only like two colors in the whole thing. Yeah, it's basically acrylic. Okay. Each to their own. Just I it's something that goes in my mouth. I don't want to get too vibrant. And we're a bit like that. We don't really make stuff we wouldn't use ourselves. Yeah, some of those stab woods look quite cool.
I see what you're saying about the force start, but I've got kind of a different idea. Wow, that is loud.
It's the sound of the police.
Yeah, I know.
So it says you've had a lot of non-ceramic vibrant objects in both. Yeah, but they're soft. They're squidgy. Yes, my mouth, yes. You got a pretty mouth.
All right, so what I think I want to do here is I want to put four cuts into this guy. Flat cuts against the thread so that you basically take the switch and you push it up and you just turn it and it'll just one turn and tighten.
Jay's just sent us a something to try out. Wonder Vape Co 270 Mech Mod. Sounds similar. Do you remember like Andrew's at that?
Yeah.
I'm just ignoring you, Steve, because you're a potty mouth. You and Mike, you two in the same room would be a nightmare, I reckon.
Oh, yeah, this is the same one we just looked at.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, this is the one we just saw in the video.
Ah.
And they don't show us anything about the Switch, really, which is the bummer.
Greybick says, any chance of maybe a new meme icon RDA like a Pepe? Do you know what? Okay, so we've been this close to Pepe for a while, but it's just, you guys are so territorial at the moment that I don't want to upset half the vapors in the world by having a Pepe. And I've got this amazing Trump icon vector that I've been working on for some time, and I've used it in the past for dry hits trolling. Mm-hmm. It's brilliant. It's absolutely brilliant. But now he's like the president. I don't feel like it can just, you know, like if we did an Obama one, I think we'd end up in some trouble, and I don't think it's fair to do Trumpy.
Yeah, we might. People are really like still very angry. I don't remember this for this long after an election of people being this.
No. Obviously, I was a bit out of Thatcher. She was my prime minister when I was a kid, but you know, it was kind of after. Like, she'd done her damage and she'd been in her way, and maybe people had opinions about her. And some people still love her today, but I remember, like, in real time, some drama, some madness.
Yeah, this is, I mean, are people still that upset over Brexit?
Most people just want to get on with it now.
Yeah, that's what I figure, right? I mean, not to be like, most people. It's done, stop, you know, Ramoners and stuff. It's just like, well, you know, that's democracy, and sometimes it's bloody, but, you know, it's over. Let's make the best of it. We're all going down in the ship together, I guess, right?
Well, some of us, maybe. I'm going to jump, but... I think the problem with Trump is that because it's so tribalized now that, and actually Obama as well, if I'm honest, there was a period of time when George W. Bush would make a mistake or make a bad policy decision and Republicans would bash him for it.
Right.
And then he would make some good decisions. I mean, after 9/11, he came out and said that our war isn't with Muslims in America. American Muslims are our friends. And, you know, it was like a day after, and it was just what you guys needed to stop, you know, sort of, stop horrible madness. Yeah, like beatings in the street and stuff, and liberals said, yeah, fair play to him, you know, he's got a good heart. And then, like, now, or since 2008 really, you can't be complimentary to someone who's on the other side of the aisle, I guess. It's kind of sad because Trump might do some great things for vaping, and we're just like,
yeah.
Or he could take us into World War III, and I want Republicans to say, hey, don't bomb North Korea.
Yeah, yeah, chill out just a little bit on that, bro.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I hear the people that live on the Falklands Islands are super Thunder Thatcher. Hell's yeah. I love it. It's our little troll base in the South Atlantic. A little troll base. They did, I really, really hope we don't have any Argentinian subscribers, but, There was a thing where our military, due to the recent like war on terror and stuff, is pretty razor sharp. We got the F-35s coming, Queen Elizabeth and Prince Charles coming. Yeah, it's going to be the third largest aircraft carrier in the world. Some really cool stuff. And our army are like razor sharp because they've been fighting for like 10 years. The Argentinians still have the same Air Force foundations they had in 1982.
Wow.
And they saw that. So our latest destroyer was so good that the American Navy asked us to turn off some of the subsystems because it was just basically like cheating because it was such good tech. And it's amazing. Our new destroyers are incredible. And basically they're saying that one destroyer can take out every aircraft in Argentina before it takes off. One destroyer, because they just haven't got any EW, they haven't got any real capability. Their systems are 1980s stuff. The pilots are poorly trained.
Apparently you guys still have the deactivation codes for all their French tech.
Yeah, that as well. Yeah, which we threatened nuclear war. We were going to nuke Buenos Aires, which is just crazy enough to work.
Hey, I'm from Buenos Aires and I say kill them all.
England needs not to build a new navy and instead build a new infantry weapon. Ooh, ouch.
Burn.
Oh, deep burn. That's a good weapon system, man. I enjoyed, after the A2 came out, I enjoyed that rifle. I don't think Mike shot an SE-80, A2.
Really?
Yeah, because the A1 was utter horseshit, and I only used it. I was quite lucky I dodged it for most of my service. I only think I had it for 6 months, and then my A2 came in. It was like, HK just ripped the guts out of it. I was like, here's German. I guess it's better than rocks and no, Mike. I don't know how you're going to get hold of one in the States, but honest to God, it's basically just a HK. It's like the furniture is all the old British stuff, but inside is a brilliant German weapon.
Oh, how are you going to get a hold of it? That's easy, man. We've got HK's building a new factory.
Ooh.
Yeah, they've got a contract to supply their M4 variant to the Marines.
I do not approve. All right. I will defeat you at 300 meters every time with that rifle. Unless he has an M14, and then it's game over.
I'll take that bet, James.
Did I just say it the wrong time? Mouthing off.
Oh, your camera's in the wrong spot, Corey.
Yeah, I can't see you, so I'm just mouthing off here completely unashamedly. Yeah. And then you can just call me out. Because you're a way better shot than me.
I'm listening. I'm just doing end of day with the kids, and then I'll be on for an extended period of time.
It's a good rifle. It's a good rifle, but yes, it took Germans to fix it.
So you guys were talking about the 416 that HK is going to start supplying to a lot of the regular military forces in the United States.
Yeah, well, I'm hoping that out of it, I get me some Cold War era HKs because Bush banned them. Bush 1 banned them.
I gotta kill my Facebook because that's where I'm getting the reverb from.
Oh yeah, that'll do it.
Yeah.
What was the HK that was in response to the automatic ban, and they basically made it look like a rifle. So instead of having a pistol grip, they bodged it into a rifle grip. Have you seen that? It's like it's a gray thing. It's like totally 80s.
Not the MP5.
No, it's great. I mean, HK.
Is it a rifle caliber?
It's 5.6. HK. I mean, it's an assault ban rifle. Because it is really interesting, because it's like a whole bunch of compromises, but actually ended up looking quite cool. Images. There it is. Oh, it's weird. It is the HKG-36.
Oh yeah, the polymer thing.
Yeah, it's insane looking. Like it's Stormtrooper-esque.
Yeah, my buddy who lives here in PA with me, he's a gunsmith and a firearms manufacturer. He actually has a G-36C that he is taking from D-mil status and bringing it back into regular status. And since he's a manufacturer, he can keep the full auto lower. So pretty cool. Hard job to do, kind of. You kind of got to take your time with it and not rush it. But, oh, man, you should see some of the toys he has. He has a he has a factory HK MP5 SD silencer and, like, the whole upper. Like, and you can't get those You can't buy those in the United States. You can only buy them as dealer samples, I think. And even then, they're very rare and limited. So he showed me that, and I was like, no way, dude.
So our we have a bunch of guys called Company 14. They've changed the name now. They're the Special Reconnaissance Regiment. But they were the guys that were like special operators in Northern Ireland. And they used to wear trench coats with those rifles inside them.
The MP5 SDs?
Yeah.
Dude, we've been using that gun since like the 70s. I think earlier than that, like late 60s. To this day, it is still used in service. Like, that's how great HK firearms are.
No, exactly.
And that's why I'm excited about the factory opening back up, because I'll be able to buy a new one.
Honest to God, that SA-80A1 would stovepipe on me. And I was all right. I knew what I was doing. It would stovepipe like incessantly, and the magazines were awful, and the bolt, everything was bad. And then HK was just like, yeah, we need $1.5 billion, please, to sort this crap out. And I just gutted it.
Oh, you're talking about your L86?
Yeah.
I always wanted to shoot one. I haven't shot one yet.
Really accurate. Really accurate. And it comes to the standard SUSAT, so.
Bullpups, it's 16 or 18 inch barrel. I know they come in like two different variants or something.
So we had the LSW, which was a bipod one as well, but it didn't really work out.
Yeah. Oh my god, monsters. Get out of here, monsters. Sorry everyone, I'm not on LSD. I have two children. The camera's just not on right now. I just, you know, dealing with them right now. So I saw that you guys were working on a tube for a mech mod. Have we thought of a name for it yet?
We haven't.
Right. Okay. Now, how? What are we rating this show that you guys are doing right now? Is it PG? Is it R? Is
no,
it?
No, I swear like a trip right now.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's R-rated.
I'll think of a good name here in a couple minutes.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, the cool thing about it is we're doing a 2700 battery in it.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Trying to get a little bit weird here.
That's cool. I mean, that's the thing. I mean, I know that, you know, I don't want to derail the discussion and take it away from
derail
the
away.
Building. Derail but away. In the firearms industry, they're talking about innovate or die, and I think that's a good thing for any industry, is to keep the ingenuity up and keep creating and driving innovation. Otherwise, everything's just going to kind of become stale and just die out.
Well, so, that's kind of what they're hoping for, isn't it? With the FDA deeming and stuff, they're trying to, for some reason, stop the progression and the innovation.
Yeah, because I mean, that's all the lobbyists and all the funding and stuff, where they're getting it from big tobacco is, you know, they want to crush the e-cigarette culture, which is sad because, you know, it's helping people quit the nasty, hey, sweetie, you're okay. I don't know if you guys can hear that.
Yeah, it's cute.
Yeah, she got her head stuck between my leg and the ottoman.
No.
And the other one's laughing at her. Oh my God, twins.
Okay, cool. Well, Corey, do you want to come back and join us when you're free?
Yeah. I could still use that same link, right?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. I'll just shut the laptop up real quick, and then I'll be back here in a minute.
Okay, sounds good.
My brother, good.
All right. Later.
That was Corey. And possibly in the future, we'll be making some kind of cool gun stuff. But I think him idling on the three-person chat killed our our Zoom thing. I gotta find a way to fix it.
Does it kill us even though it's just two now on the remaining meeting time?
Yeah, it looks like it. I know. So here, let me I'm gonna go and restart it real quick, and then we'll come back. Sound good?
Yeah, sounds fine.
All right. Cool. All right, guys, sorry for the lag. This show's only semi-professional. It'll be more professional sooner. There's James. James is back.
Hello, London. London calling.
Cool. So we got some weird stuff going on so far. And that's what I wanted to kind of...
Yeah, keep it weird.
Yeah, well, we were... While we were chatting with Corey in the background, I was hammering out some weird stuff here. And that's basically the way our Switch is going to work. And what I've done is I've put these indents in here. And it's so that you can...
Tell you what, I'm just going to unpin something and then repin something. If you want to give us a quick heads up of where we are. Quick rundown.
Quick rundown, yeah. So... We're trying to find a way to do the switch easily and quickly. I don't think this is going to work though. I think we actually need less thread exposed than more to make it a one turn. This is something I actually haven't worked on before, so I'm a little bit. It's something I want to learn. And now I gotta go listen to the class.
What's the dimension of it again? Is it 20 mil?
It's a 2700 battery. Right, the entire thing is 25 millimeter in diameter, and I think what I've done is not going to work, but I think something similar would need to be done to make it work, because I think I need less thread pushed in than more. Anybody have any feedback on that, on how to make the half threading work?
Okay, I'm going to pin that. Pinned.
Yeah, I'm gonna leave that here for now, and let's start on the top cap, because I think that'll be kind of interesting. Let's draw.
Is there any way of squeezing up to 26 so we can stick the?
Yeah, can do the
squonky guy that we designed the other week. Yeah.
Yeah. So. Maybe...
Yeah, because you know the idea of having all those crazy graphics lasered onto the new top cap on that 26mm RDA.
Mm-hmm.
We can grab some cream ceramic and etch the same pattern onto the sleeve. I think that'd look fucking dope. Like, cream and gold.
So you want to do a sleeve on this guy?
Yeah, if we can. Yeah, I think that'd be pretty interesting. Yeah.
I think 26mm just gave us enough width to do a sleeve too, so let me...
Sound. Yeah, because we can do a black and a cream one. And just have lots of sterling and gold. Just make it really look better than the Legionnaire. Because I've got beef with Germany, if anyone's wondering.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah. Love Germans. Some I don't like so much.
Some not so much. Some Germans.
There's a few.
Some Germans are not best Germans.
No. It's kind of revenge, I guess.
Ooh, revenge. The plot thickens.
That's fine.
All right.
Can't all be the best.
Let's cut our. Oh no. We're gonna cut our sleeve indentation here. Make that 23.5. Too thin.
Blake says he's gonna go listen to the Clash.
Yeah. Pumping out the fat jams today.
I was listening to the Pointless. Just leave the Germans alone. All right. I just said a few of them. I like 99.9% of Germans.
Oops.
I can't have beef with any nation that drinks that much beer and eats that much sausage.
They definitely eat a lot of sausage.
They do. And they're all in England over Christmas, and it's brilliant. I just go to the German markets in Chester or Manchester or London, or even I think there's one in Liverpool now. Everywhere is German markets in the UK. And I just get fat on Glühwein and currywurst. So good. Blake says, where you will see what looks like a three twist thread when in reality there are three independent threads.
Yeah, that's kind of it. I think I need to read the basics. I need to get down to basics on that because I'm not as clued in as I'd like to be. There we go.
Even Southampton has one, and that is the back end of Beyond. That's the where's that America? That's like the New Jersey of America. Of England.
Yeah, Corey says I just got a name. I'll reveal when I hop on again. You guys will still be on about 20 minutes. Yeah. Yeah, we will.
Yes,
he also says James loves the sausage. That's true.
Not going to lie.
Not going to lie. All right, cool. So, James, take a look at that. That looks good for...
Oh, you froze. Why have you froze? Yeah. Give me some screen, man. Okay. That was cool.
Good at that?
Yeah. How thick does that allow us to have the ceramic?
It's a 0.5 millimeter diameter. And I think the other thing about that is we're going to need to make the entire top cap thread on in a weird way. So we should actually make this cut extend all the way through, or else you won't be able to change the sleeve out. So we're just going to drag that all the way down.
Yep. When we sell this, if we do go to market, we will need to provide batteries, and I want to design some Doge sleeves. Because I got the pattern in your hat. You see that one in your hat? I can do a vector cartoon version of that all over the batteries. It'll look amazing.
Would you guys buy Doge batteries? I know we haven't sold batteries in a long time, but I still have connects to
some... Yvonne.
Yep.
Yvonne's our girl.
Yeah, and so...
Who was she again? She was Eve...
No, she's from Sony.
She's from Sony, wow.
Yeah, I was getting them direct by the case on the pallets.
Beat Elon to him. No, he's Panasonic, isn't he, Elon?
Yeah, but I don't think that's going to last much longer after the sodium ions. He had to have known because he stopped work on the Gigafactory. Yeah, he was supposed to build 7 sections, then he built 1, and all of a sudden just stopped. Gray says, will the sleeve spin? I've seen a new Chinese sleeve mech with an O-ring to keep the sleeves from spinning.
That's cool.
That is cool.
Do it.
I've got a really good idea for how to make that work, actually. And add some flair. Let's do it right now.
Do it. Oh, okay, so the soundboard, I want you to grab Emperor Palpatine's do it. So if anyone suggests something, you just go, do it. Do it.
I got this.
I am the father.
Not bad. I'm really jealous. I really want one.
What, the soundboard?
Yeah, I'm going to have to get one from my iPad and just have it.
Yeah, you could probably get a cheap one from I don't know if Curry's... Does Curry sell you stuff?
I'm just enjoying Nathaniel comment. Joy Serrano is master. Just to make a panzer.
Joy Serrano.
I love that guy.
He's great.
I need to invent a plug-in for Chrome that changes your text to the way he writes. You know, the O's and
yes.
stuff.
Yes. Yes. Zero. Big uppercases.
Yeah. Cool guy. I think that was my first ever proper expensive mod, actually. The Golden Army thing we did on the Congregate.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
No, the Black Hawk. Yes, wow. It was a Black Hawk. So I did the graphics for it. Mike says he's under shelter in his place while they chase a murderer down in my area.
Really? Shelter in place and arm up. If you take him down, you get the bounty, Mike. Just kidding. Don't do that. Please don't do that. Hold on. I need a media converter.
Are you doing the do it?
Mm-hmm.
Fair enough. We're doing the O-ring.
Yeah. I'm going to do the O-ring in a second. Right. I'm inspired about the O-ring. But this just must be done. Download.
Steve says, I will catch you in a bit, dickheads. Lovely fella. What a lovely chap.
What a lovely guy.
Do it.
I gotta boost the gain on that sample a little bit. And yeah, I'll boost it way up and then we'll crop it down in Ableton.
You ever seen In Between Us?
Do it.
That sounds good. Yes, you've showed me In Between Us.
Yeah, with Jay. He always reminds me of Steve a bit.
Blake says, I remember my Blackhawk Panzer clone. Mine was junk, but there were some badass clones out there. You know what? We sold the actual Blackhawks, and we sold so many of them, so many Blackhawks, that they had to make a special run just for us of Blackhawks.
I'm going to grab my graphics I did for that, because I was quite proud of that.
Yeah, that was good.
I had fun back in those days.
That is when we were just having fun, huh?
No pressure.
No pressure, not a care in the world. We were living in pots, but...
There's nothing wrong with a pot.
Nothing wrong with a pot. It's a Diogenes reference, guys. We don't smoke weed.
Oh, yeah, that's a point. Anyone might think we're endorsing pot. We're actually discussing earthenware vases. Giant ones, pythons, or whatever they're called. Yeah. Oh, I love Diogenes.
Right. Now we're going to want to make this guy... Make him 2 millimeters tall. And then we want to apply a color to him.
Oh, Steve didn't like the J reference. Good. Do it.
Do it.
I can't find the graphic. There it is. 2014. God, times were simpler back then.
Mm-hmm.
Where's the graphics going? Oh, you son of a...
Cool. Okay, guys, so you see this? We'll make this out of a rubber. Right? But this will go in and it'll wedge in between the switch and between the sleeve. So then
Sound?
So let's save that. Thank you for the inspiration, guys. Whoever called that out is gonna get a special mention on the packaging.
Yeah, who was that guy? Hang on. Was it Blake? I think it might have been Blake. The Panzer by MCD. Where's all my graphics gone? I think a lot of this stuff got rationalized. Fucking sashin.
What does rationalized mean?
No, there's just some big, beastie, hefty images on there. I just got him to replace them with simpler ones just to speed us up.
There we go. And then we'll save that guy. Just cheating. Save him as our sleeve. Let's throw the assembly together. And our base component.
So I gave my Black Hawk to Poland's number one e-liquid reviewer.
Did you?
Yeah, he was such a lovely guy, and he took us. So he was only supposed to meet us for like half an hour in a pub. And then we had such a great time with them that he then invited us out the next day for dinner at his favorite restaurant with his family.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, we spent 4 or 5 hours together. And at the end of it, I was like, I feel really bad because I don't have any gifts. But, yeah, we'd pick up the tab and stuff, but he was just like insisting to pay. And I was like, I feel terrible. So under the table, I just gave a bit of a clean, got the shit off it, and presented them this thing about. And he'd not really, I guess Poland is a bit starved for good kit. And so it was his first like genuine high end piece of gear. And he was, close to little Polish tears.
Close to little Polish tears.
Oh, I fucking love Poland. I had an argument with someone the other day on Monday's post. Because I said, if it wasn't for Poland, England would have been like up shit creek because they helped with the Enigma program.
Oh, I saw that.
The pilots were amazing. Yeah, and then the guy just won an argument. I was like, oh, because I wanted to talk about history. Like, I was genuinely looking for, you know, if you're pro-Soviet, then tell me about it. Let's talk history. I'm equally appreciative to the Soviets as I am anyone who helped out, you late motherfuckers included. But no, he just wanted a tribal fuck fest. I was like, nah.
Yeah, well, that's the problem. Nah. You read, Jim.
Yeah, as I said, yeah, what history are you into? Like, reference some interesting books. I'll stick them on a reading list. And he's like, yeah. Wow. I've gone weird on him. I'm reading some good stuff at the moment.
Are you?
Yeah, the biography of Gene Kranz. And he's a real dick tease because obviously everyone wants to know about Apollo 13.
Mm-hmm.
I'm halfway through the book and he's not even got to Apollo yet. So he's just like leading me on through Mercury and Gemini. And yeah, sure, it's interesting, but I want to hear like, Houston, we've had a problem. That's all I want. The Polish just need to put wings and lances on their tanks back to world power status. Actually, Mike, they are releasing a tank at the moment that's one of the best tanks in NATO and it's all stealthy and black. It's pretty badass.
Stealth tank.
Yeah.
Yeah, Poland might be the very last hope for a strong European country that is not capitulating to anybody's bullshit.
I mean, the only one in Europe outside of Great Britain that are growing economically.
Yeah,
I also, 5% growth last year.
I also think they might have a Polexit.
Polexit. Yeah, possibly
Polexit.
Polexit. Yeah, sounds good.
Sounds good. We gotta coin that.
Polexit. Well, guess what? The Polish tank has been built in partnership with British Aerospace.
It's BAE?
BAE Systems, yeah.
Of course it's
BAE.
That's
why it looks so cool. All
right, guys, this is what we got. We got the tube, we got a sleeve, and the purple dealie is going to be our O-ring. VC4ADV raffle for advocacy coming soon. Yeah, I could get into that. Give me some information. Actually, why don't we do a raffle today? Raffle? Do a giveaway?
Raffle.
Yeah, I got some stuff.
Yeah, I got some bits as well, I guess. A lot of this stuff's just clogging the place up. The tank, Mike, is called Main Battle Tank Obram PL-01. And the title of the video says, Better Than US Military M1 Abrams.
All right.
Nothing's better than a Charlie.
This is what I got today. I got a black, all-black Doge tank.
Like a Polish tank.
And I got a gun-gray Doge tank. Yeah, I got a stealth Doge tank. James, what do you think we should do for a giveaway? Should we do the first one they did? It was a like a viewership contest deal.
I always like the memes, but I don't think we can drop images into the comments.
Yeah, you can. It's just a little bit.
Yeah, it's not free flowing.
Yeah, it's not as free-flowing as we'd like. Let's see, can you...
We can do it on the page, I guess, afterwards.
I wonder if this works. Let's see.
What we can do is you can do it on the page, and then we can drop your best best meme, and the winner can get a tank or two. Sheldon says, seems like it came back just at the right time. What, because we're talking about tanks or because of the raffle?
Either one.
I've never really watched many other Vape Live things. Do they talk about politics and weapons as much as we do?
I don't think so, but I think we're curating our audience, right?
Yeah, just a bunch of nerds. No offense, it's a compliment.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's the thing. I think this is supposed to be a little bit more of a nerdy live stream anyways, where we, you get to learn some stuffs. I want to see if that works. I don't think it worked.
It's working. It's just not terribly organic.
Mm.
I think we'll do it after this live stream. For an old like and share type bullshit, I guess. Is that, who is that, by the way? I miss.
It's just some random off of Giphy. But I'm trying to see if it'll load up into the...
It's working.
I'm trying to see if it loads onto the on-screen chat.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
Sheldon.
Flood the inhaler.
I like that, actually. That's pretty not
bad, is it?
Corey's promising he's going to come back on with the name to end all names for us.
Flat the inhaler.
Yeah, it didn't work on the chat.
No.
Bummer. Okay.
I was trying to get my girlfriend to enter into Miss Kekistan the other day. She wasn't having any of it.
Well, you know, the SPLC has deemed Kekistan a religion of hate now.
Really? Yes. Already?
It's a religion of hate.
Jesus Christ. that nation, it's a young nation. It doesn't need... You know, it's like Palestine.
Yeah, I know. Just
needs to be recognized by the UN Security Council. I tried to sign up to the non-binary gender support group.
Mm-hmm.
And they make you fill in a form before you can join. And so my pitch is that I'm assuming that DNA coding is infinite to some extent, right? You don't get many humans that are the same.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to say, if human beings are infinite to an extent via coding, trillions and trillions of possibilities in this code, then gender must be infinite as well.
It is, yeah, that's true. I think gender...
Right, so anyone who doesn't agree with me is a homophobic, genderphobic bigot. I'm top-trumping these assholes.
Nice. You know, my whole feeling on DNA is that compared to all other things in the universe, living things are infinitely more complex. It's like we have these really basic things like granite or like dirt, right? There's your basic like carbon, hydrogen put together, and then you have DNA, which is like this incredibly dense data set system.
Yeah, it's intense.
It's intense. I feel like that's where we're going to find the intelligent design, and people are just going to, I think it's going to be like, I don't understand how we go from rocks and water to all of a sudden this incredibly dense data system. It just seems like too big of a leap for me, but we'll see.
I mean, so people say that you're only like 80% away from a banana, mm-hmm. and like 97% match with chimps and stuff. I mean, yeah. It's pretty nuts, isn't it? As a base, that's nuts.
Yeah, it's like...
Why does a banana have 80% of our complexity?
Right. It would be like loading up a jQuery library and then writing your application over the top.
Yeah, exactly.
So there's like all life on Earth is like at least 40% the same DNA, and then...
Mm.
You're just like a little tiny sliver of specialized code over the top. It's crazy.
There's a sect of maths that just... Oh, maths. Sorry, we say maths in England because it's short for mathematics, but hey. There's a sect of math that just studies knots to figure out how DNA is replicated.
Hmm.
I find it quite exciting because Steve Jobs couldn't get his DNA done in time, could he? It was too big a challenge before he died of cancer.
Really?
And now you can spit in a tube and they get it back to you within a week.
Yeah.
It's nuts, isn't it?
It is nuts, but I don't like the third party sales
aspect. Yeah.
That's a little creepy.
You're being put on a register somewhere.
Yeah.
And not the fun registers that I'm on.
Not the fun registers. With...
D would have got that nicely. He's definitely on some lists.
Okay, cool. Let's make our top cap, guys. What do you guys think for a top cap? Where should we go with this?
Make it gold,
huh?
This is all gold. It's gonna be a real high-end looking motherfucker.
All right, let me go back and drop some gold on it,
because that ceramic's gonna look sweet.
I think we just want to gold everything now, right?
Illuminati eye. Yeah, definitely, that's happening, definitely. Sheldon says you don't get fully sequenced with those services.
You don't, huh?
Okay. Because they tell you where you're from, so I guess they're just having a rough stab at the basic stuff.
Mm. Yeah, I got it done actually at the doctor instead of getting it done through one of those weird services. And he said, I am extraordinarily high in Neanderthal DNA.
Are you? Because there, I read. Oh God, what's his name? Yuval something's Homo Deus.
Mm-hmm.
Really good, by the way. If you get spare time, bang that out. It's really interesting. But he's saying those studies are being held back at the moment because there's a racial element to it, because Aboriginals tend to have, and this is fact. This isn't any viewpoint or opinion. They have higher Neanderthal DNA elements. Mm. And so the idea is that all humans under human laws of being treated equally, but actually in science, and it's really, really quite dangerous for a lot of people to discuss that there are some parts of human communities that are more or less human than pure Homo sapien, if you know what I mean.
Right.
But it's very controversial because you're saying to some person you're less than human. So
see,
it's just an interesting thing, facts versus sort of application of opinion, I guess.
Yeah, that's true. I think, not to plug Jordan Peterson, but I watched a really good lecture he did. And he was basically talking about the way that Hitler got everybody into hate the other, hate the gypsies, hate the Jews type
thing. Yeah.
And it wasn't so much as the dehumanizing is more, it was treating them as a disease, saying they carry mm-hmm, disease mm-hmm.
Eradicated and a virus. Yeah.
It triggers this part of the brain, the disgust response.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
It's something that you do when something's dirty or something like that. And that's really what did it. So I don't think the dehumanizing aspect and saying, hey, we're different, we're all made of different stuff is really... I don't think it's as dangerous as people think it is. I think it's more the way you treat people when you start, when Trump said that Mexicans are carrying disease when they come, I think that was one step in the wrong direction.
Yes, well, the right direction if you want to build what you might be trying to build.
Yeah, exactly. If you want to get people riled up and worried.
So the soldiers that were in Poland during the occupation, the good guys, I guess... because obviously we have a lot of respect for German soldiers and stuff. They were just doing as they were told. There are elements of the German army and actual German heroes. I'm a big fan of Rommel. I've read a few books about him. I love the guy. That they wouldn't go to Poland because the way they were instructed to treat the population was completely, they couldn't understand it. Like, well, if you But if you piss them off, they're going to fight back. You're just going to cause trouble. We need more and more soldiers. They should be on the front line. We don't need any mini rebellions and revolt and stuff. We're not really feeling what you're saying here. Mm-hmm. And so Hitler sacked the main man that was sticking up and saying it's not how it works, and promoted a guy who was in prison for paedophilia at the time.
Oh, named, Jesus Christ.
Dolwanger.
They're basically people capable of horrible acts.
Yeah, and so he went in, and the German army, like the regular normal guys, were like, holy shit, this guy's a psychopath. And so basically over a period of a year, it was just SS rejects and borderline criminals and sex-deprived paedophiles, all the nastiest possible Germans you could possibly imagine, all flooding into Poland. And yeah, they were under the guise that they were doing a cleansing system and that the Poles were vermin and stuff. And they were able to kill thousands and thousands of people completely, you know, without even thinking. You know, there's sort of no thought process because they'd been drummed into the heads that these people were a plague of rats, no different to, you know, sort of the black plague and stuff.
That's how you do it. So it's the disease.
Yeah, well, it's just the kind of stupidity, because obviously the German soldiers would have been well trained. You know, they had basic training. They would have worked as a team. They would have been respectful men, and they weren't having any of it. So they had to get, you know, special, well, you know, stupid Germans in to believe that shit.
People came.
Which is why education is so important to me.
Yes.
Because if you have critical thinking, if you have enough people saying this is dumb, let's not do it, even the most tyrannical person can't get ahead. But when you have a dumb population, anything can be achieved.
Yeah, exactly. Especially people who don't know history. They're bound to repeat it.
Mm-hmm. I'm out of bounds. Yeah, that's one book. It's Warsaw 1944. It's quite triggering. I read it for an hour and then I have to leave it for a week.
I thought I did that right. Okay.
Oh no.
What's up?
Jennifer. Y'all still here? Hey y'all.
Yeah, we are, Jennifer. And you're
Oh my god.
You're free
We're to talking on. About tube mods.
And you're free to come on and troll with us if you like as well. James doesn't want it.
It's just a bully.
All right, we're cutting the threads right now for our top cap.
We had all these wonderful names, suggestions for the name of the theme of as I was talking about eradication of people.
Yeah. Read them back to us. Read them back. What do we got for names?
Writing
this Blake. Chat up.
Everyone here in Texas says y'all. Okay, so Blake earlier said the Illuminati, I call it the Big Brother. Mm-hmm. Nick Barr said Ciro Stratus. Sheldon, Illuminati I would be pretty sweet. It's Blake's suggestion. Nick said Stratus. I should be quite good at clouds. I was studying clouds last year for my pilot's license. I should know more. And I made an app for the Waypoint that had wind and cloud formations.
What were the cloud functions on that again? So I just remember the knots.
I wonder if the app's still alive. It must be. The Waypoint app. That was a sad. We could have never have done this in the marine industry.
What we're doing right now?
Yeah, we'd have like nothing going on. Oh, it was beautiful. It was absolutely beautiful. That's hard to look at. Look at those knots. They were really good. There's a very talented girl from Sheffield who did those knots for us.
Great. I think you'd really enjoy this Jordan Peterson thing.
He actually
tied that to the authoritarian versus democratic thing to the prevalence of communicable diseases. as people are more afraid of disease, they go to a more authoritarian, like they go government save me kind of thing.
Really, so he's a psychologist?
Yeah, University of Toronto?
Harvard. Oh, University of Toronto, yeah. But he did go to Harvard.
Yeah, he's dangerously smart. Dangerously
smart.
So his
smart influences guy. Are Dostoevsky, Nietzsche, Jung, Skinner, Rogers. Oh, okay. He's a fan of Orwell. Nice. Ah, and Aldous Huxley. Okay, I'm in. That's what I'm doing tonight then.
Yeah, he's not a fan of Nietzsche and like the whole like
Yeah.
I don't know, depressed teenager sort of way. That makes sense.
Yeah, I mean I've given Nietzsche a bit of a go, but yeah, you're right. It's like, I don't know, like fashion.
Yeah. I think Nietzsche gets a hard rap because the Germans based so much of their Third Reich bullshit off of it.
Darwin gets a bit of a stick for that as well, but it's not, if you have an idea, if someone implements it badly, you should get caught up on it.
Exactly.
I'm all about cameo anyway. This is so miserable. I'm like, oh. When at the end of he gets into a fight on the beach, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then he shoots the guy. When the weapon draws on the floor, he picks it up and he shoots this attacker. And then he goes, and the whole process, he can't comprehend why he's in trouble because he's done the good deed and stuff. Mm-hmm. And then when they say you're going to be executed, he's like, well, it's better than all this shit, I guess. I'm like, I can so just appreciate it. You know, it's just like the sort of, yeah, do you know what? It's not that great anyway, is it really? Kill me. Mike says, give me that Sartre. You can trust Sartre because he can look at an entire room at once. Yeah, this isn't your typical vape group.
No, it's not. Sorry.
It's fine. No, I'm definitely, yeah, I'm going to have a good day. So you said he was with Joe Rogan the other day?
Yeah. But the thing I'm actually referencing is a lecture he put up on his YouTube channel a couple of days ago. And he's talking about the disgust response in people, and kind of what makes that whole mechanism tick.
Oh God, Reddit: 10 reasons why podcasts with Jordan Peterson left me conflicted.
Yeah, well, at least like if you disagree with him, you really got to work to disagree with him. You can't be intellectually lazy, which is something.
Well, that's why I like Shapiro so much.
Yeah,
big fan.
You gotta work for it.
He was having a run-in with some feminist, some social justice warrior, and he basically said that he hates bullies. You know, I don't know why you would think that I would be a hateful person because I was bullied ferociously at school. And I'm like, yeah, I get it. Like his little whiny voice, his little kippur and stuff. He's like, I'm like, yeah, I can see it. This guy's had a hard run to adulthood. He definitely isn't a bully. It's funny actually because Milo was going to have a debate with him. Everyone was like bigging it up,
mm-hmm.
and Milo just ran a mile. He's just like, but every thread it was in and every comment was buried and hidden and deleted. He was just having none of it.
That would have been good.
No, he would have got thrashed.
I got plenty of sleep last night, so I'm not making nearly as many mistakes as I did the last stream from the warehouse, which is good. Even though my banter might not be up, that's because we're trying to get a lot of work done really fast today.
See, that's how I felt the other day when I was doing those logos in an hour.
Yeah.
It's painful. I need to develop that hexagon dog actually a bit further.
Hexagon dog. Oh, yes, the polydog. Polydog for the pup.
Polydog, yeah. Well, it's tricky because the reference material I got was a different type of dog. I've got to turn it into a Shiba Inu.
Okay, chat, what do you guys think of that? Check it out, Jim. Are you guys happy?
Oh, Corey's back.
For top cap?
Corey's back.
Ooh, just in time.
Hello.
What up?
What up?
I'm coming to you from the depths of my basement.
with your neck beard.
Beat it, nerd. So hey, anything to keep 2 1-year-olds from screaming and crying their heads off.
Oh, yeah.
Do you have a Bumbo?
A Bumbo?
Bumbo, yeah. Have you seen them?
No.
Oh, the Bumbo was like... So, as a new parent, having zero clue how to do adulting and parenting, we got this thing, it's Bumbo. It's like a rubber, like a potty, like a chunky potty. And it's got a split down the middle, and you pop them inside, and they're comfortable, but they can't move.
Oh, I don't know if you get like that thing.
Yeah. Oh, dude, that is such a parenting hack. She loved it because she's up and looking around. She felt like she was part of the conversation, but she can't wiggle away. It's just genius. For like when she grew out of it and started like, oh, I want out. I was like, stay just a little bit longer.
Just a little bit longer.
The Bumbo is so good.
We had one, but they outgrew it so fast. So we were just like, whatever. But we got this thing. I don't know why. What's up with B words? But it was called a boppy. It's this cool thing, and it's a twin boppy. So instead of just, it's like a little padded horseshoe with like microfiber polyester, like nice stuff. Anyway, you just sit them in it, and then they just lay there and chill and do what babies do, I guess. So that's been a lifesaver. We still use it. We've had it for over almost a year and a half now, and that thing is fantastic.
Tabitha liked to hang from the ceiling on the little bouncy things as well. That was something she'd be happy in for hours.
Did we have a thing? No, the only thing that we had that with were the little cradles that rock back and forth, like the little seats that you put them in. One of our kids, she would not just go straight to bed, so we had to put her in that, and then she would rock to sleep, and then we pull her out and put her in bed. Oh my God, it was a nightmare. But they slept. Ever since 3 months, they just slept all night long, which was amazing. Nice. So we're...
Some parents, they're like, oh, like you see them in work or whatever, and they're just like completely bleary-eyed. And it's like, oh, I've been up since 4. Abs would go to bed at like, you go to bed about 9-ish, and she'd get up at 7. I was like, I couldn't understand why everyone was so tired.
Yeah.
Well, you're doing it wrong, guys. You're obviously not as good as me.
I think since 3 months, they slept from like 8 to like 7 in the morning.
Oh, beautiful, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Twins, both children.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Oh, my God.
It makes you love them more because, like, I've always been very open and honest with parenting because I just don't see the point of bullshit. If you've got an ugly kid, you've got an ugly kid, right? It's true. But Tabitha, because she slept through very early, from about 3 months as well, I've always had this, like, just this positive vibe about her. She's always been a good egg, and she gets maybe more than other children just because she's always been so cool. And some other kids are like real. You see them, and they're like, so she had a birthday party recently. It was like 20-odd kids. And there were 2 or 3 who were really funny. And I was like, genuinely, like, 8-year-olds were making an adult laugh like quite a lot. They were really cool kids. And there was like 17, like, just, where's the ice cream? And I'm like, oh, go away. Just
go grow up.
Yeah.
go play in the dirt or something.
Maybe chill somewhere else because, yeah, you're dim-headed.
So where are we at with this thing? The good, unnamed device.
Good question.
So we're waiting on a name.
A name? So yeah,
to bring it.
I think, well, initially I thought of the motherfucker, but I figured that wouldn't go to market very good. The motherfucker. But then I figured what size was the battery? You said 26600?
No, 2700.
2700.
It's a new battery.
So that thing's like massive, no, not like an 18650, which is like...
It's 20 centimeters.
Yeah, it's 2 millimeters wider.
So that means a larger deck area than right on potential RDAs that you can put on that thing, right?
That's right. Yes.
So I was thinking, why not call it the MOAR, the M-O-A-R. More. You get more deck space, more battery, more device, more everything. Why not just call it the MOAR?
I like that. We can nick the color scheme off the MOAB, you know, that kind of nice olive green and yellow. So that's a good looking bomb, right? It's an attractive weapon.
I think they tried to make it look sexy, but that thing is just hideous.
It's because they get it quick.
This big thing that they just have to launch out of a C-130.
That's nuts.
Yeah.
As good as it's done quick, because wasn't probably a superior F-35 design was rejected because it looked too much like a big gaping kind of mouth hole.
Yeah, yeah, the Boeing YF YF-20. No, I know. Yeah, it's the YF something. Yeah, it had a big guppy mouth, and actually, it would have cost about half the cost of the F-35 because it was a one piece carbon thing. That's why the thing is so guppy. It's because it was a one-piece wing sandwiched and then also clay, and like ovened to form this big substructure for like the airplanes. It made it have this goofy front, but the brass were like, yeah, it's dumb.
It's just so it just didn't look menacing enough for them, right?
Yeah, basically, yeah. It was sleek and angry.
You ever see the movie The Dictator?
Yeah, I love it.
Oh my god, he's just like, where's the pointy tip on the missile? The whole nuclear program goes to shit.
Goats running around.
Oh my god, that movie.
It's a good film.
It was pretty funny.
When he's walking down the high street of like New York, what is that, like Times Square or something? Oh, America, birthplace of AIDS.
Oh, Jesus.
Or was that Borat? That wasn't The Dictator, was it?
Yeah, that was. Yeah. He's marching down with all his entourage, all the women in the
and the Lambos and stuff.
Yeah. Which you see in London sometimes. I think it's the Kuwaiti royal family are in London a lot, and they have baby blue, royal blue, whatever it is, Lamborghinis and stuff. They'll park outside the front of Halfords, and they get ticketed to buggery by local traffic wardens. They're like, fuck.
It's okay, I'll take a million tickets. I don't even care.
Yeah, I literally don't care. Yeah, literally.
Oh man, I don't even want to talk about supercars. Just so many wants.
I don't like cars full stop.
No. What kind of supercars do you have your eye on? Because one of my early jobs was working on supercars as a mechanic, as an apprenticing mechanic. It was probably one of my dream jobs. So what kind of supercars are you looking at?
Okay, so I like to break it down into three different categories. I like to say there is a realistic one, then there's a more, you know, a little bit above that, getting into the unrealistic zone, and then there's completely, utterly unrealistic. I will never be able to have that unless I pinch and save and do everything in my life to be able just to buy one. And only have it for a month because I can only afford it for a month. So unrealistic or realistic, I think the R35, the GTR, is the best affordable platform, at least for a budget supercar, because what you can do with that thing is incredible. Just the amount of parts and aftermarket support, the tuning, just even right out of the box. I mean, that car just performs well, track, just street, just cruising, just whatever. So I like the GTR. GTRs, at first I dogged it, but not anymore.
Yeah. My complaint with that is unless you live around the corner from the Nürburgring, you're pretty much not gonna ever get the bang for the buck out of it. I don't think you like it. But go on.
Go to open days with Laguna Seca. They have open days where you can take your car and stuff. You're in California still, right?
Yeah.
So
for now.
There's options, okay? I mean, you don't have to be all super, you know, fast, furious, street racer or anything like that. But, I mean, it's almost like a gun. It's rather have it and not need it than need it and not have it. Uh-huh. But then you can get a little bit more out of the realistic area and go into somewhat unrealistic. And I think I'd have to say the Huracan. The Huracan is somewhat an affordable Lamborghini. It performs. I mean, I believe it's slightly under the Aventador as far as price range is concerned. Or the Aventador, I forget which one's more expensive, but, you know, I don't really track supercars. But I think that if you can budget it, I think you get a little bit more and a little bit more supercar and a little bit more flair with it.
So if I had my own mechanic that lived in my garage, I would have the Countach or the Lotus. Is it Elise, John, the one that was in
the Elise?
Yeah.
Or the Exige?
Submarine one.
Yeah. If I could, yeah. The Lotus Elise that with a different engine.
With a ruby red interior. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it'd be well been.
Not the Exige? You guys wouldn't want the Exige with the supercharged package?
Nah, I like older things.
Oh. Oh, yeah. So you mean old.
Old. Yeah. Roger Moore, man.
Well, what was in... What was in the latest Bond movie? What was that, the DB4?
The latest one was the DB2, which was a prototype car.
Yeah. Yeah.
They sold one, which was not street legal.
That thing was hot.
I think Mike kind of agrees with me. There's Jaguars, there's old XJ Jaguars. They replace pretty much all the guts with modern stuff. So you can have reliable, you can start it in the morning, power steering, all that sort of stuff. I quite like that. There's minis as well that are now putting power packs in France. You get the Mark One Mini, which is beautiful, 1959 Mark One Mini, but the bottom of it is all batteries, the back's all batteries. And yeah, you just start every time and charge it wherever. It's still a beautiful looking classic car.
See, I've been in PA now since March, and I have not seen one recharge station. And I'm just like, why would I go buy a car that I have to charge if I can only charge it at home?
For British people, and maybe myself, what's PA?
Pennsylvania.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, sorry.
That's all right. I know a few initials.
Mike says he's driven the Exige and the Elise, but they're not fun for the 30-plus-year-old back for any time on any road.
Yeah.
So
our old ass is probably. And I'm 6'4", so I probably couldn't even fit in that thing.
Jesus, you're 6'4"?
You didn't know I was 6'4"?
No.
Yeah.
James, you must have felt like a manlet when you went out there and met him.
Nah, I compensate in other areas.
he's this way.
Yeah, I am. Yeah, that's depressing.
I told James he must be this tall to ride, and he did not disappoint. Anyway, yeah, we had fun at the shooting range, that is. No, I did not see James's wiener. No, we went.
Evening was special too. Yeah.
I went and gave him a taste of freedom.
Yeah, it was a perfect American day, wasn't it? Because we shot the shit out of things, including going full also on the. Oh, that was nasty. I can't remember what it was, but it was like just a flame machine. It was a beast.
Yeah, that was the 7.5-inch short build rifle, the full auto machine gun that we shot, and then we shot one that was. I believe it was a 7.5-inch or it was a 10.5-inch, but it was suppressed. So the actual cycle rate of that firearm was, I think, a third times more faster. That thing was ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. Yeah.
We had a lady next to us who was just with her husband, sort of just doing sort of basic pistol drills. And she brings her target in, and one of our lot just lets rip a full mag dump, and it just shredded her target. She looked so upset, but she had the whole rest of the range were like, "Woo, go get him, yeah!" Torn to buggery.
Yeah, that range was cool. I'm kind of upset that I moved away from it, but I got to shoot so much cool stuff. I shot all those machine guns, full auto AKs, and then I shot a suppressed Barrett 50 cal there. That thing was It was interesting. So Barrett, they were doing like some charity thing, and you pay like $10 for 3 rounds or something like that. So I gave them, like $20-$30 now.
What's the recoil like on that?
It's not bad, actually. I mean, for its intended purpose, I mean, I have some buddies that went through the CPIC course for the Air Force, or the Close Precision Engagement course, and the Designated Marksman course, and they got to shoot that stuff, and they got videos of them holding it, double firing it, and stuff like that. But as far as recoil, like I wouldn't say it's any more harsh than a 300 Win Mag, or even a hot load 308, like a M118LR. It's a typical training round that we use, that they use in the armed forces. So it really, I mean, with the silencer on there, perceived recoil, it wasn't that bad.
Okay.
So I liked it.
You see people firing it. I think I saw some footage in Afghanistan, and all the dust was coming off his uniform. It's like he's shaking everything out. It's amazing. Just cleaning for the day.
That round, I don't know. If I had an extra, $8,000 to $10,000 to buy one, I would. But I mean, that's just money well spent elsewhere. I can do at least another 6-7 projects with that.
Yeah.
So. Buy a full auto lower.
Yeah. How many engine blocks do you need to put these on?
Engine blocks. I don't know much about that. I wouldn't say
I'm
too
saying
much
with the Barrett. With the Barrett, like, what are you going to shoot engine blocks, basically?
Oh yeah. That's what it was designed for, or what we used it for when we were in Afghanistan. It was an anti-vehicle, anti-personnel rifle. So, disable engines, disable vehicles, disable goats, I guess, if they're riding a goat. But it is what it is. We had guys in towers when they were there, and they had these things called gongs, and the gongs would be at specific ranges down through the approach point onto the installation, and they would shoot the gongs, and the gongs would go ding, and then you see the truck, truck would slow down, you know, because they'd be like 500 meters out, and they wouldn't hear the report until it was too late. So they designed the gong thing. They shoot the gong and gong ring, and then they would an escalation of force thing is what they would call it. Kind of give the person an opportunity to cease what they were doing, their hostile, perceived hostile actions, before we schwack them and, you know, put them six feet under. So, and unfortunately, you know, you get some people that just don't understand that. And then you get the actual people who come up and try to bomb the base, and then you find all the explosives inside of their vehicle. So anyway, I digress. Enough of that nonsense. I'm trying to think of different names that we can call this thing.
I think we had it. Let me go through the chat real quick and see if I still got it. We had a couple good ones.
Let's see. That's our group chat. Let me check.
No, not the YouTube. Nautilus, Luke.
Mm-hmm. Like, if you read back through the chat, we've got cars, warfare, philosophers, some stuff about vaping, tanks.
Oh, so these people can't see how ugly I am on the YouTube thing, can they?
Occasionally, yeah, you'll pop up occasionally.
Oh, that's weird.
Yeah, because you can only have two faces and a screen at a time.
Oh, that's fine.
Nick Boss,
you're alive now.
The Stratus, it isn't that bad.
Oh. Try to see the comments here.
Vlad the Inhaler.
That one's pretty good. All right,
I'll be right back, guys. Give me one sec.
But I really like the more.
I mean, short, simple, to the point. It stays with, I guess, you know, the ongoing theme that you guys got.
MOAR, yeah.
Yeah, like more.
More. I'm gonna put some dots on that. Then we need to find what that could stand for.
What? Mother of,
yeah. Have you seen Guardians of the Galaxy?
I have seen the first one, and I'm waiting for a better copy to pirate online. Allegedly pirate, just in case someone's watching.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I watched it the other day. It's really good. But
the second one or the first one?
The second one, yeah. I won't spoil it for you, but there's a very, very cool set design that I'm going to nab for this the ceramic sleeve on it. I'm going to try and oh my god, Mike's just said mother of all robo dicks. You've got a winner, definitely a winner.
I want to know what happened to my thing. I think it. For some reason, I'm still signed in, but I can't see the video anymore. That's weird.
Yeah, Facebook's a bit of a bitch for that.
Oh, I'm not even on Facebook. I'm signed in through the Zoom thing.
Oh, okay, gotcha. Yeah, I have Facebook running in the background just so I can keep an eye on things.
People are probably like, man, these guys are fucking boring.
Yeah, just having the... We don't get that so much. I think it's because we've cultivated the audience. Most people know that we're dweebs and they're fine with that. Yeah. Reading through the names here, most of the dweebs, I know quite a few of them. They're dweebs anyway.
What happened to you guys?
So we asked for people to suggest what more could stand for. Uh-huh. And Mike says mother of all robo dicks. Which I think is a winner. Although Blake does say mother of all RDAs, but I think what we could do is say it's mother of RDAs, and then just say robotics.
Yeah, I like more. I think that could work good.
Yeah, it's cool, isn't it?
Yeah, it's very cool.
I try. Now, if I can just figure out what happened to this video thing.
Sheldon says the mother of all.
That's good.
That is good.
And just have the, you know, the screeching guy, and have it say FDA on it.
Vaping intensifies.
Yes.
The triggering.
The triggering. floating 510 clutch firing system or magnet firing, preferably clutch or either, maybe a sleeve system or easier customizability, silver plated contacts, 18650, but maybe adjustable for smaller batteries.
Yeah, I'm reading them.
Delrin, around the 510, like broadside, sort of battery rattle adjuster, different finishes like brass, copper, and aluminum. Mother of all batteries.
You can have any finish you want as long as it's ceramic. Do you want different colors? Aftermarket, third parties. We ain't making no bright colored shit.
Yeah, it is sleeved, but as far as 18650 goes, we're actually going with a 2700.
Mm-hmm.
18650s.
Sheldon wants to add a chicken tendy logo. So Sheldon and others, please do suggest images and ideas, because it's going to be covered in all sorts of swirly patterns and Greco-Roman type things. But what I can do is squeeze tendies in and a little pepe here and other bits and pieces. So we'll have like, it'll be me malicious, but from a foot away, it'd look very Art Deco, Greco-Roman sort of, yeah, ivy and bricks.
Yeah,
and
so
I'll throw up some mock-ups.
As you zoom in, it'll get weirder.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Zoom in for weirdness. Blake says, mother of all Romans. Yeah, we're getting, that's good.
I think that'll kind of work. Let me see if I can just pull the entire assembly from the other one in. Actually, I don't need to pull the whole assembly in when I can just pull in the top cap.
Nick Cage. Whoa. Oh, that's genius. My girlfriend's just tagged me in something. It's absolutely brilliant. How do I get that in the group? Oh, damn it. Oh, it's so
more.
I went to my cousin's May Day celebrations where they dance around the pole and stuff, and all I could think of was the Wicker Man.
Really?
All these little kids in little dresses dance around the Maypole, and there's like lots of singing and happy clapping and drums and there's some torches. Not the bees!
Was that thing actually...
No worries, Jeremy. No worries.
Wow, was that thing actually 28? I think I might have accidentally designed it as 28 millimeter. At least the top cap. Because that doesn't look right.
I thought it was 26.
I thought it was 26 too.
Bugger.
So you're saying it's button fired, not on the bottom fired, right?
It'll be bottom fire, but we've got a special switch that we did last year, Jim.
Yes. Yeah. It's cool. It's really slick.
Does it lock?
Yeah. So okay. Basically, a quarter turn is a lock and another quarter turn is open, but it gives you that little, that positive haptic sort of feedback as you click around. It's really neat.
Wicker Man is a film for generations, Mike says. Oh, don't worry about it, Jeremy. You guys' feedback is what makes the show interesting.
Yeah, no one wants to hear us yabber about psychology.
Yeah, psychology and war and...
philosophers and war and, yeah.
Yeah.
Although we should do a Let's Draw, which is about weapons tech and war stories.
Well, I think we'll get there. No, Corey, would we have the ATF all over us if we just started free designing?
You can design all you want. It's when you manufacture that's when the issues come into play. So, I mean, design all you want, design away. You got the flow test stuff on that too, right?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I can give you tons of ideas. So I mean, until you get the physical stuff, then that's when it becomes kind of shiesty. So like these people who make solvent cans,
yes,
or solvent traps, yeah, those people are dumb. There was like two guys that just got raided within the first quarter of this year, and they're in some big trouble. So.
Good. Yeah, those guys, I see them at the gun shows, and they're selling the kits, and I'm like, you're just asking for it.
Yeah, they were such douche bros as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What happened with the? It was a couple of years ago where they had put the 3D parts online, and the State Department came in and shut them down.
I'm trying to remember that.
It was like right when, I think right when like Defense Distributed launched. Yeah, it was them, and they had their designs for like the AR-15 lower, and they put it online, and the State Department came in and shut them down and made them take the files down.
That's crazy, because I mean they're really not violating any sort of law when come to think of it. I mean, they're just sharing ways to manufacture your own firearm. So it's like the stuff, like, you can find all the measurements for an AR-15 lower anywhere online. Like, you just Google the dimensions, Google how to mill it out, and it's there. So, I mean, I don't understand, like, what the big deal is. Hey, look, you can 3D print your own lowers. You can go out and buy a block of metal that is already cut out, you know, the 80% lower, so.
Right. Yeah, I didn't understand that much. Did not understand that much at all.
Yeah, it's, I stick to, I mean, it's people pushing the boundaries. I mean, I, you know, before I would have released anything, I would have researched the laws and understood, you know, what I'm potentially getting myself into, because you're talking about something that's very controversial and something that's heavily regulated in the United States. So you don't want to set yourself up for failure and not do the right thing. You know, that's why when I get into firearms and when I start manufacturing and doing stuff, I want to be able to understand those laws and be able to be knowledgeable, because, you know, my customers are going to have to rely on that. The people who I give advice to are going to have to rely on that.
Right.
And if I tell them one thing and they go break the law, you know, am I going to be culpable for that? Hey, Corey told me, you know, if I do this, this, and that, I'm not violating any law. And then the ATF or, you know, federal government goes knocking on their door. Yeah, you actually did. And now you're culpable for this, this, and that crime. So I just, you know, I just buy from reputable companies, and I thoroughly research and understand the laws, rules, and regulations concerning that stuff. Just like with all my NFA stuff, you know, I manufactured my own short barrel rifles. You know, I can manufacture my own silencers if I wanted to, but I'm not set up for that. So it's understanding the law and how you fit into that, and then executing it. And if you want to push the boundaries, then so be it. But you're asking for your own repercussions.
Yeah, exactly. And no, Sheldon, we won't be having it double as a suppressor, just because I know a guy from Sacramento a couple of years ago who he got in trouble because the ATF tried to say that his mods he was manufacturing silencers, and they raided his house, and then they tried to say his VG and his PG was explosives.
Yeah, big barrels of stuff, yeah.
Yeah.
And I remember you guys were talking about that a while ago.
Yeah.
Yeah, just, that was nuts.
It just got way out of hand, so.
And he was really into spinners as well. You know, that sort of guy who's a bit, you know.
The ATF knew. They saw the spinners, and they saw that he had three dogs, and they're like, we're coming. That's a three-dog violation. We're shooting all three. How was that in Afghanistan, working with a service dog?
Well, I wasn't handling a dog when I was in Afghanistan on my first two tours. I was in a different part of the Middle East when I was working a dog, and that area was a relatively calm and what they call a vacation area. So you do your Googling online and look up cake military deployments, and you'll find a lot of places that are pretty easygoing. So, not to say that there isn't a threat, because there's always a threat. It was just a lot relaxed and laid back. So it was kind of nice. Still busted our ass doing 14, 16 hour days, but, you know, it was good not to really have to look over your shoulder everywhere you go and be cautious all the time, even when you're on the installation. My second tour in Afghanistan, it's actually coming up on the, I think it's the 7-year anniversary. When the attack happened, it was a attack occurred May 19th in 2010. And they say it was the largest ground-based attack since Vietnam. And to an extent, I can see how that was exaggerated to get to that number, but I don't believe it because there's COPs and FOBs that are attacked a lot more heavily than I think what Bagram was at the time. And it was like, they say it was like 20, 30 people, but it was nowhere near that. The people I was working with and working for, we know the exact numbers and how many people who were involved, what country they were really from, and all that other fun stuff. So really, it's the comparing the two would and saying it was hard when I had my dog, it would be a disservice to everybody. So my third deployment was a vacation for the most part.
I red-pilled myself because being in SIGINT, you're in the community, you know pretty much what's going on accurately. You know, everyone feeds back this pipe of information back to the UK. And when you're responsible for the pipe and you help feed the pipe, you know most of the truth. Yeah, sure, contact reports aren't always gonna be accurate and some people do get excited at the time, but you pretty much know the truth, you know, 4 IDs, 1 VIB. You just learn the flow of things. And so when I got back home and read newspapers about actions that I'd been involved in or had been very closely supporting of, I was like, holy shit, the media just lies? Like, I always had doubts about the media, but this is like explicitly lying about things that happened, because here's the facts. And now actually with WikiLeaks and Chelsea Manning and Snowden and stuff, I see the reports that I was responsible back, you know, 7-8 years ago. Seeing, you know, one VIB, one PAX casualty, whatever in the reports, a couple of pages, you know, and then it'd be back in the newspapers in the UK, and you're like, that's not even... no element of truth in this at all. You just fabricated. And I was like 24, 25 going, holy shit, the world is fucked up because political decision and people's like opinions are being guided by something that is absolutely not true.
It's just in that they're overblowing it or they're underplaying
yeah,
it.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
That it was overblown. Well,
bloodshed and death and all that other stuff and like literally war sells. So it's, you know, well, go figure that these people are doing that.
If it bleeds, it leads.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's just sad. I guess, you know, people are with the internet. I guess it helps a bit, but yeah, just to know the truth, because sometimes you know that, like with vaping, we kind of know the truth and we know that they're talking shit. But like when you've from the best source possible on the ground, and you read it a few days later, you're like, oh, these people, oh, damn them.
I actually may have footage. I don't have the footage, but I think somebody uploaded it onto YouTube of the May 19th attacks on Bagram.
What year was that?
2010.
Okay. Ooh, I was out by 2009.
What about 2009?
I was out by then.
Oh, you're out?
I was done and dusted. Yeah, I'm old.
I know it's on Live Leak or WikiLeak or something like that. Mm-hmm. Raid on Raid Camera Bagram. I know it's on here somewhere. I figured if I'm going to torture all the viewers here and the listeners, I'd rather give them something to appease them. Let's see here. Live Leak Bagram Raid Camera. Oh yeah, there was a crash in 2013. There was a giant
Oh, the 747.
Yeah,
that was. Yeah, damn, that footage is intense.
Yeah, it just goes up and then.
Was it? I think the Lodi had made a mistake, and one of the MRAPs slipped back and changed the center of balance on the aircraft.
Yep.
That's just heartbreaking.
How much trouble did he get in for that?
Sorry.
How much trouble did he get in for that?
I don't know.
They died.
No, the loadmaster.
The loadie.
Oh, who knows?
Because they were contractors, weren't they? They weren't military at all, so.
That's a dangerous job, and that's a lot of responsibility.
Oh, tons, yeah. They're really well paid in the British Army. I think you come out of training like as a sergeant or something ridiculous like that. That's crazy.
Okay, cool, guys. Well, hey, let's wrap it up for the day, just because we're I think we're going on hour three. We're keeping it a little bit long. I think Corey's suggestion of the Moab, I'm with that. What about you, Jim? Do you like that?
Oh, all the way. Yeah, m.o.r.a.r, the mother of all robot decks / RDA.
Hey, it's a work in progress.
It is progress. And if you guys have a better name for the Ackerman, I think that you guys should, you know, let us know. Corey, I want to thank you so much for coming on. I want to have you on in the future, man, more often.
Yeah, let's schedule a proper one.
Yeah,
definitely. I do need practice with public speaking and stuff like that.
Oh, you're fine.
I'm a little bit out of practice. When you first pulled me on, they're like, hey, get him on the channel. I was just like, oh, anxiety. But after, you know, talking and realizing, you know, it's laid back, I think.
Yeah.
I definitely appreciate it.
Everyone in the chat's always so friendly. We're quite lucky in that respect. No one's posted us on a raid board yet.
Yeah, we haven't been raided yet. No, we have really good people who watch these chats. So we're, you're in, it's a safe space.
Oh, I got plenty of things to defend myself. I don't need no safe space. But I appreciate the warm welcome, and I will definitely hop on more and work with you guys. Yes. I mean, I would like to learn as far as like how to use these programs and how to do stuff. But I figure, given like the common person perspective, I think that that's definitely something that could be of value.
Yeah, definitely.
So we'll see.
Sounds good.
Definitely. Cool. All right, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us the whole entire time. If you stuck with us, it's been lots and lots and lots of fun. Join us again on Sunday for the next Let's Draw at 2 p.m. Pacific, 10 p.m. GMT. 10
GMT, yeah.
10 p.m. GMT. And yeah, again, this is Let's Draw. You guys get to design the stuff. I just draw it. And come back again. Thank you.